Hey, good evening, everyone. It's your girl, Storytime with Ms. Ty. Thank you so much for joining me. I am really excited. I have a really amazing story to share with you guys today. It's a story I wrote called I Love Trees, and I really hope you enjoy it. But before we get started, I want to do something a little bit different. I want to introduce you guys to my very lovely, very trendy. This is my story jar, okay? So every time we share a story together, what I will do is I will deposit a lovely shiny quarter into that beautiful jar, just to let everyone know, so we can all recall and remember all the fun that we shared along this journey, okay? So without further ado, I'm going to jump right in, okay? This story is called I Love Trees. I love the Bay Area. That's where my family and I have been living all of my life, more specifically in the city of Hayward. You gotta love this place. Even in the winter, we can expect the sun to peek its friendly face over the horizon. Although I live in a family-friendly environment, Mama takes me to a park called Burbank rather often. At first I thought, gee, lady, can we get more of the SpongeBob series instead of the trees and grass? I mean, sheesh, until one day my entire life changed. I was sitting under a huge, beautiful tree, minding my own business, drinking a Capri Sun, and nearly jumped out of my skin when I heard, excuse me, aren't you gonna say hello? Who said that, I questioned. Why, I gotta be a who? You humans are so racist, he spat. Us humans, I mumbled. Yes, you humans, he replied. At least you could have said, good afternoon, thank you for shielding me from the blazing hot sun. He replied sarcastically. Where are you? I asked. Right up here, of course, he snapped. My eyes slowly began to stare from the ground up, and within seconds, I was locking eyes with a talking tree. And might I add, he had a bit of an attitude. I nearly crapped myself when he asked, so are you just gonna stand there staring at me all bug-eyed? No, sir, was the only reply I could think of. Well, since you have disturbed my peace, I can no longer enjoy my nap. So would you like to hear a story? He asked. Ever since that day, I never saw the park or trees the same. Mr. Tree has really grown on me, and dare I say he's my best friend, but I'm not really sure on his. From that day onward, any opportunity I can get, I beg Mama to take me back to the park so I could once again speak with the talking tree. Mama, can we go to the park today? Asked a vibrant, anxious first grader. Sure, Tamar, the park it is, right after breakfast. Now sit down and give thanks. Yes, ma'am, Tamar responded before sitting down, closing her eyes, and giving thanks. Everything smells divine, darling, my father said to my mother before giving her a quick kiss on the cheek and sitting at the table. Mama handed Papa a large cup of steaming hot coffee as they shared a gingerly smile. The looks on their faces beamed of pure love and joy. Before long, Daddy was headed out the door to work, and Mama and I were on our way to my favorite park. Burbank, here we come, I sang out in glee. Mama chuckled. Baby, why do you like that park so much? Because of the talking tree, I yelled. Okay, settle down, Mama said softly. Moments later, our SUV pulled into the parking lot, and I could hardly wait to get out of my seat. As soon as Mama turned off the car and took off her seatbelt, I quickly took off mine and raced for the door. Slow down, Tamar, and remember, what are the safety rules? Don't talk to strangers and don't follow animals or children away from my area, I blurted, headed straight for my favorite place in the whole park, under the talking tree. Mama smiled and watched me as she headed to a nearby bench while taking out one of her favorite books. Hello, Mr. Tree, how are you today? I asked, standing directly under his enormous branches filled with rich green leaves. Large blinking eyes appeared as if Mr. Tree was just waking up, and his baritone voice boomed with the response. Hello, Tamar. I'm just waking up from a much-needed nap. What brings you here today? I really wanted to see you. You're my favorite tree in the whole world. Aw, now that's kind of you. Would you like to come up for a while? He asked. Yes, please. I squealed. Mr. Tree lowered one of his beautiful branches to allow Tamar to climb on too. Once on top, he used a thinner branch as if to secure her seating like a seatbelt. As Mr. Tree began to rise Tamar to eye level, she squealed with delight. Whee! Tamar now sat 7 feet from ground level and could see the park a lot clearer. Mr. Tree, will you tell me the story about the breathing dragon again?
You got it.
But first, let me grab some water so I can wake myself up. As always, I love watching him get water. It started from his roots wiggling deep into the ground. Then the water could be seen slowly moving upward through his trunk and branches. Finally, a majestic smile would creep across his face. Mmm, that was good, he hummed. Are you ready to tell me the story now, I whined?
I think so, he replied with a smile.
Okay, so long ago, I lived in a place called Patch Hill. It was a beautiful place filled with birds, bees, and all of nature's beautiful things.
Your mama lived there too, right?
Of course. What would a home be without a mama, he chuckled. There was a huge, tough tree called Theodore, and most of his leaves were constantly gold. He was mean, spiteful, and very bold.
Did you fight him? Tamar asked, as if she hadn't heard this story before.
No, I was just a child, he replied. And this story is about Theodore. Theodore had the town's people living in constant fear. At night when the humans would sleep, he would even pick on deers. Then one season, a dragon came to town. He was bigger and meaner than Theodore had ever been in town.
Did the dragon kick Theodore's ass?
Before she could finish, he chimed in, "Now, child, watch your mouth. One more outburst like that, and I'm sure to put you down."
I'm sorry, Mr. Tree, I just got excited.
So where was I? Oh, yeah, the dragon came, and Theodore told him he wasn't invited.
The dragon said, "Brother, please, all that pollen falling from your big head makes me want to sneeze," and then turned up his nose as if he were bougie.
Theodore replied, all that hot air you talking, man, it ain't about nothing. Like Michael Jackson said, you want to be starting something?
Tamar bust out in laughter.
He didn't say that, Mr. Tree.
No, he did. Girl, trust me, he did.
Then what happened, she asked.
They began to square off, of course, until Teacher Applegate came and told them violence never settles the score. Finally, out of one final move of spite, the dragon said, "You know what, Miss A? I think you're right." In one slick move, he was all over Theodore. He blew him a fiery kiss, and we didn't see him anymore. Theodore dug up his own roots and headed out in the night. His branches jingled as he ran. Now that was quite a sight. At that time, Tamar laughed so loud that tears filled her eyes. Mr. Tree began to laugh too, which jiggled every part of Tamar, including her thighs. Now this noise caught the attention of Tamar's mother as she called out with a slight fright, "Tamar, it's time to go now. Is everything all right?" Tamar's mother began to walk in their direction. Mr. Tree saw it and made a quick suggestion. "Tamar, perhaps we should continue telling stories another time. Your mom's on her way up, and you know what? We're all out of time."
"Okay, Mr. Tree, thanks for the story. It was fun.
Come back and see me again, and I'll tell you another one."
With a gentle shift of his branch, he lowered Tamar to ground level, where she quickly met her mom, eye to eye.
"Tamar, was that you laughing?" she inquired with an intriguing eye.
"Yes, ma'am." "I was thinking of the funniest story," she replied, while winking at Mr. Tree and waving goodbye. The end. So that concludes this story regarding Mr. Tree and one of his wonderful experiences with Tamar. So I hope you guys enjoyed this story, and I hope you'll come back to share many more. I'm not going to hold you too much now. It's time for me to go. But remember, until next time, there's always another story to tell. But for now, I must go. One, and many more to come. Good night.